Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. It is 6:10 on Monday, September 29th. I'm Ryan. I am the play-by-play, and here with me is Connor Lohman as the caller, and on camera is Aaron Cochran. Today, Spartans varsity volleyball is playing against Turner Falls Indians. And JV actually did pretty well and won all three games. Today's game is brought in part by the Pizza Shop, home of the legendary dough, located on Shaker Road in East Long Meadow.
They have very good pizza there. Oh my god, that's delicious.
Made out of they have the sugar in it too. The extra sugar makes it well worth going too. Indians making a good start out of the first game, leading it 2-0. Double hit. Balboni. Way out, spot his point, first point of the game. Caroline keeping it in. Not going to score a point. She sets it for Decker. Number 6 and number 12 colliding into each other and missing the ball, playing for Spartans.
Sounds like we have some singing going on in the crowd right now.
That's pretty awkward.
Yeah.
Oh my god. Beautiful serve by Rachel Walczak. I mean, that actually deserves a replay.
She's been having great serves all season. Great teamwork there on Spartans' part.
Spartans catching up now, making the lead 6-5. Looks like the Indians are actually losing a lot of their organization. And it's kind of paying off.
Just Rachel Spikes are just like an unstoppable train right now.
Her serves are really well. I mean, she's doing pretty well tonight. Double hit Spartans. I think that's one of Spartans' weaknesses is double hits. They get a lot of double hits as a team. It's something we got to work on.
It is getting very repetitive. And it always seems like it happens when they're trying to do the same exact type of play.
It's always the set when they're setting it up for a good spike. It's just the double hits, they're ready, and then the double hit just ruins that. It's just deal breaker. Yeah, I was saying, like, number one just completely took over number 11's zone. I mean, he said completely. It's a little
embarrassing.
Disorganized. I'd say disorganized. Number one is going everywhere right now. If you watch her, she was just running around the whole court. Decker not ready for that spike over. Couldn't save it.
Miscommunication on the Spartans.
Wasn't ready for that. Yeah, I don't think they were ready for that serve. And then just a simple error made by Babylon. Nothing I could. I mean, you criticize her about. It was something that it's just human error.
Difficult serve to fight back on.
Yeah, whenever a ball is coming straight at you, it's hard, no matter what sport it is, it's always hard coming right for your torso. It's the hardest thing to ever get. Catch, deflect, whatever it is, it's very awkward. Set made up to Seuss.
A nice spike by Seuss.
Right before the line. Way too far out, number 12.
She just launched that.
That was, I think that was going to the soccer field.
Maybe even the JV baseball field?
Maybe. Paige coming out of nowhere, getting that spike over. Sets it. Baloney sets it over. Out. Good call by Caroline O'Connor. Creating a good volley here. Elena sets it for Balboni. And that's it. There's another point for the Spartans.
That point will put the Spartans in the lead 14-10.
First, I wasn't thinking the Spartans were going to do too well, but definitely redeemed themselves. Oh, Caroline with a beautiful save. What a great save. Avoiding collision. I'm not sure, but either avoiding collision or thinking the other person is going to get the ball. Connor and Balboni kind of stopped.
Just barely made it over the net there.
Set over, Elena saves. Balboni sets it away over.
Too many people swarming around inside the Turner's Falls side over there.
Double hit, Turner's Falls. Trying to block. Unsuccessful block. Balboni keeping it in, Rachel getting it over. Out.
A little too much force on that by the Spartans.
I think they were just all amped because they kept it inbound. Serve over, net ball. Walczak gets it back over. So made to number 7, Rachel Walczak blocks it. Another block by Megan Lindsay and Rachel Walczak. Point Spartans. Serve. Double hit. Spartans point. Timeout. Unions. We're going to take the timeout as well. We'll be right back. And we're back in the first round as Spartans are leading at 19-17.
They did not start off well after that timeout.
That was, it was just too powerful of a serve. Sophia trying to bump it to either Seuss or trying to get over the net. Kind of missed it a little bit. The net. I'm sorry. It means touch the net, Spartans point.
Couldn't make the spike over the net there.
20-19.
This game's really gonna come down to the wire here.
Yeah. Let's see how it turns out. 20-20. Seems to be evenly matched though. I mean, they've been doing pretty well against each other. Double hit seems to be very repetitive. Serve just right, a little bit outside. Double hit, Elena Tilly. I actually did not see her double hit that time. I didn't notice her double hitting. Might be something I'm missing or from a bad angle. Couldn't seem to make it back over. 23-23. Spartans have to make these next 2 points without the Indians making them to win this round. 3. It's over. Hit the top. Hit the ceiling out of bounds. Indians ball. Sets it over. Ooh, Richard there to get a spike, and it's not gonna be able to be recoverable. And it's still tied, 24-24.
Spartans need to get 2 points here in order to win the game.
One of the points.
Just one more and the Spartans will have it.
Come Becker
amazing save.
Oh. And Spartans just watch it hit the net.
Came just about 3 inches too short.
Yeah. It's too bad. Bounds, causing the Indians to get back the lead, 26-25. They're just sprinting to keep it out. And that is game, 27-25, Indians. We'll be back.
Sports fans, stay in touch with all of East Longmeadow High School sports by following us on Twitter using our handle at LCAT Sports. And if you miss any of the games on TV, you can watch the game at your leisure by visiting us on YouTube and searching LCAT 01028.
It was on video. Now, the Spartans make it back out with their very disappointing loss. And it is, seems to be starting out pretty well. Sue serves it over. And it sits with a serve that Carolina O'Connor saves. It up 70, hits it out of bounds. Point Spartans. Well, is that continuing her beautiful serves?
Could not get the spike over the net there.
She sets it. For Decker, making a point. Almost a beautiful save from the Indians. until the hit off the ceiling, of course.
That was an amazing volley right there. They were just trying to save it the whole time.
They
were doing a great job, too.
Number six trick by Decker Spike. It would have gone out of bounds, actually. She kept it in and gave the Spartans a point. A flubbed spike by number one. Oh, Paige Seuss with a good love tap over. Double hit. Seuss sets it to Decker.
Put it right where no one was.
I'm sorry, what?
It was a hard hit ball right where no one was.
Oh, my God. That was beautiful. Spartans are doing well with their serving their spikes tonight. No doubt about it. Spartans stepping up their game and actually winning 10-3 this second round. Let me rephrase that. 11-3. Timeout, Indians. The coach is getting a little anxious. We're going to take a timeout as well. Sophia with a beautiful block. This is actually an unstoppable game right now. Sophia and Paige Seuss. Miscommunication. Not always good. Spike over. Nice reconfiguring there, the ball. Out! Caroline calls it out and it's out. Out by 5 miles. And it currently getting subbed in. And Indians making their 6th point of this round. Keeping it alive. Ooh.
Came up just short of the net there.
Just short of the net. You know, that's difficult to figure out if it's going to hit, go over the net or not right at that point.
Sometimes it just loses all velocity and just drops.
Yeah, I mean, you don't want to risk the chance if you're going to hit the net. Sorry, Spartans got that point back. Almost a collision. Albani makes it over. Double hit. Number 9 with a failed serve. Dead silent as Balboni makes a serve, requiring full concentration. 17-9, Spartans leading. Bumped up. They see herself a kind of a love tap over. Oh, and Megan Lindsay's there to save the day. Rachel Walczak trying to continue the legacy of this volley and hits it too far out. Decker with a spike that is not recoverable. 7 more points for the Spartans to win this round. Tying it 1-1. Nice ace by Rachel Walczak. On the line, just right out of shy of on the line. Indians not being able to recover the ball, making it 20-12, Spartans.
Lena Tilly coming in for the serve. Just couldn't get the spike over.
Blocked by the Indians. Yeah, that was, she seemed pretty disappointed about that one. Okay, just spiked over. Not making it there in time.
That ball was going way out. I don't know why she tried to keep it in, but.
Don't know either why. 7 for 17 and then subbed in for 10. Charging the ball, didn't make it in time. It'll be another ace. Landed there, recover the ball. Hayes putting spin on the ball, but not only that, no one was number 11, 6 and 11, and not prepared to make the bump. For a dive to save it. Couldn't recover it in time. 23-14, Spartans.
Apparently the floor's a little wet where Decker just dived. Dove.
Coach just keeping the towel on the net, just in case it's gonna happen again, apparently. Oh, almost a collision, my favorite part of the game. Saves it, and Sophia does successfully make it over the net. Indians making all the points back. The Spartans only need to make two more points. Way out. 24-16. Spartans only needing one more point to win this round. And they're currently making a serve. And that's the point. Spartans winning the second round. That's 1-1 when it comes to rounds. 25-16 Spartans. They're making it into round three as Rachel keeps making blocks, but if she misses them, saves them. Number 11, a little too short to jump the net and failed attempt to get the ball over. sets it. Sets it for Sue sets it for Decker, who makes a beautiful spike over. Walczak making all the Indians scared. The Spartans are gonna strike.
And that'll be four hits.
Number nine trying to get it over the net. Looks like she just pushed it out of bounds.
Carolina O'Connor unable to make it to the ball in time.
Absolutely. Number 17. Serve. Rabona bumps it. Paige goes for the spike over.
Good communication by the Spartans.
They've gone for a power spike there. Missed a little bit, hit the net. Jumped over. Four hits. Indians point. Spartans winning 10-6. Atlanta saving it from the net. Paige Seuss looking for an open spot. You mean save the ball. And a curly with a spike over.
Right on the line there.
Right on the line. Beautiful point from the Spartans.
Miscommunication there by the Spartans.
Trying to save the ball. Saves. And he goes to save it. Number six saves on the Indians.
Spartans coming back from that confusing situation there.
Megan Lindsay with the block. He says it for Walczak. And the pen can't get there in time. Point for the Spartans, 14-11. He sets it back to Decker. That gets it over. Wozniak with a great spike. Hit Spartan. That made for Decker. It goes for a bump over. Out of bounds. 16-16. For Rachel Wozniak's powerful spike.
Good job, Rach! Keep it up!
There, point for the Spartans.
Just couldn't make it on the dive there.
Couldn't pull a Decker. So close to the slides to make it over. Still 18-18.
Come on, girls, let's go, side out, relax.
This is getting to be one of those games where, you know, one team scores, the other scores. One team scores, the other team scores. It's just going back and forth.
It's going to be all five games.
It's just the little mistakes that are just going to cost them the games.
I mean, this is a fairly even team as well, too.
Yeah.
That might result in that kind of chain of win-lose. Decker. A little sneak attack there. Indians keep it inbound. And the play with a spike that number 17 saves. Number one keeping inbound. What a crazy volley that is going on here. And Anna Curry makes that volley. She gets the point for the Spartans.
Phenomenal volley.
That's a good volley to win right there.
The crowd just completely went wild on that.
spike. Now Boney not there to save it in time. 20-20. Well, another one of those games that keeps tying up to right to the very end. Good recovery by the Spartans. And the block does not work this time. Spartans point, 21-20. Keeping it in play. Spartans make it over.
These volleys are just getting more and more intense with every point they score.
Especially since it's a very close game as well. Susu making it over. Another long volley here. Ooh. Walczak not making it over. Time the game back up 21-21. Blocked by Rachel Walczak.
Come on, let's go! Sign out right here!
Getting the ball over this time.
Now, at this point in the game, if the Spartans want to win with the at the score of 25, as it normally is, they cannot let them, they cannot lose a point here.
And it looks like they're doing pretty well with that. They just tied it back up. Now they just got to get those 2 points. Points for the Spartans. Time out, Indians. Oh, celebrating, prematurely celebrating. Spartans win this one 25-20. The refs, I don't even think the refs even saw that was like 8 hits. Well, that's it for this round. We'll see you next round. Let's hopefully the Spartans win it. Here we go into the fourth round as Paige Sue starts it off. Trying to keep it up. First point goes for the Indians. Spike. Through the three and the four.
Great block by the Spartans. Just shot it right back down.
A little bit of miscommunication. That's what I'm talking about right there. I mean, like, number 8 and number 6 are both going into the net, and they never called it. Reactions gets it back over. Seuss gets it over, and everyone goes towards the middle. Sounded like a little bit of a little bit of a burn there on the floor. Here. Number 12 on the Indians actually injured her hand because Walczak served it too hard and it hit her fingers and kind of bent them back. So she's actually on ice right now. She's Out of bounds. That's for number one. Way out. Way out.
Almost had that out on the football field.
If this was baseball, they would be on a home run. One for another spike. Caroline trying to recover the ball this time. It was inside. Richard off the line. It's going to be out. And Spartans. That one with a backwards bump. Sent me for number six. A little bit too close to the net for her to execute the spike, resulting in failure.
I don't know about you, but to me it looked like she was kind of going up for a layup over the net.
Eight with a sneak attack spike. Jesus going to the outside corner for the spike. Very good volley going on here. It's very organized. Going for another spike. And the Spartans get that point.
Just one well-placed hit and it just ends the whole thing.
Balboni with the point. Sets for Balboni. He's almost keeping it in.
It's a good effort by Turner Falls.
Number 9, 10 of this. Sets it over to Spartan side where no one was. Blocked by number 7. Richard not ready for that. Covered by the Spartans. Balboni bumps it in.
Great work by the Spartans managing to get that over.
Once again in the fourth round, that it's tied up. It's neck to neck again. And ricocheted off Rachel and Megan Lindsay's arm, out of bounds on the Spartans. 14-16. Indians are taking the lead. Good call by Decker. Ball was out of bounds. The ball is actually in bounds for the Indians. The refs called it out of bounds. It should actually be 18-17 Indians. Refs overpowered the play, so it's actually 17-17. Thank you. Dudoff. The block. Six keeps it inbounds.
Game just keeps plugging along here. It's like, it seems as though it's been going on for a while now.
Yeah,
it's back and forth, man.
20-19, Indians. Only a couple more points till we figure out whether we're going to go into the next round or if Spartans are going to win it.
I don't know, but it's getting pretty intense out here.
It's getting pretty intense, you know? I mean, it's been a long day. I mean,
here we go, girls. Let's go!
People want to go home, but also the Indians want to win this. Ref called that inbounds. That was clearly out of bounds.
You know, it's really crazy because the crowd, at times, they just go dead silent, and at other times, they're just up and screaming.
I mean, yeah. I mean, it works in both ways for the Spartans and the Indians. The refs are making some terrible calls on both sides. Getting it over. Becker saving it. And then he sends it over. She sets it for Walczak. It is set over. And then Lindsay saves it. Double hit.
A long and tense serve.
Decker with a powerful spike. Double hit. Tying it back up 23-23. The Spartans need to make these 2 points in order to win the game without the Indians getting any points.
Touching it. Spartans just need one more to win this.
Even though it's out, number six. tries to keep it in, ricochets off.
This point right here could decide the entire match today.
Nobody saves it. Here's Decker with the spike. This might end it. And that ends it. Decker
with the win.
Great spike. And that's it for us today. What a challenging game by the Spartans and the Indians. I mean, it was a close call. No matter, I mean, the refs did make some pretty bad calls. That's not myself to be the judge. It's just what I saw. Overall, it was a challenging game no matter what. And I think the pizza shop played the game out, goes to Rachel Walczak tonight. She did some pretty nice serves and some nice blocks and some nice spikes overall.
I certainly agree with that.
I would definitely give it to her for tonight. That was great. That's it for us. We'll see you next time. I'm Ryan. With me, it's Connor and Aaron.